press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to the classroom. We have been discussing about the chapter Garbage In and Garbage Out. See, in the previous class, we have learned about the terms biodegradable waste as well as the non-biodegradable waste. Those waste which can be decomposed by the microorganisms are called as biodegradable waste. And these microorganisms which play an important role in the environment. And these microorganisms includes the bacteria, different types of virus, and even the fungi. These are the different types of examples of the microorganisms which can be degrade or decompose. Decompose is nothing but rot or degrade. Rot is nothing but koltu hogodu. See, decompose, and by the action of microorganisms, the waste will be decomposed, and these waste we call it as a biodegradable waste. Example for the biodegradable waste are the food items which we throw into the dustbin, and these may include the biodegradable waste. And next one is the non-biodegradable waste. See, as the name only indicates, it will not decompose by the action of the microorganisms, and such a type of waste are called as non-biodegradable waste. Do not decompose by the action of microorganisms. These waste will not decompose. And example for those waste are plastic, different types of glass, and plastic bottles and metals items. These are the waste which can't be decomposed by the action of the microorganisms, and such a type of waste are called as non-biodegradable waste. See, as we all know that water is very essential for all living organisms, not only for human beings but also for animals and varieties of birds. And even though the microorganisms also utilize the amount of moisture content present in the atmosphere. And usually the water, our planet Earth is considered to be a blue planet. See, Earth is considered to be a blue planet because 70% of Earth is covered with the water. So it is called as blue planet. And usually the water is very essential, as I told you, very essential for all living organisms. And we use water in many other activities like that. I will write on the board. See, water is present in the surrounding, and it plays a very important role for many other purposes and activities. For example, water we use for bathing purpose, washing the utensils, and even washing the clothes also we required water, and for cleaning the vehicles. And for mopping the floor, flushing the toilets, see, etc. These are the examples for the water. See, water is very essential for all living organisms, and even the plants and animals and even the microorganisms and birds require the lot of water, and for carry out the different life activities in their life. And for example, if water we use for bathing purpose, washing the utensils, washing the cloth, and like that cleaning the vehicles, we require the water. And next, mopping the floor also requires the water. and flushing the toilets and even the watering the plants also, water is very essential. For growth as well as the development of the plant, water is very essential. And these are the uses of the water. When we consider the water is a waste, when no more useful for us, we consider as a waste water. See, these are the uses of the water. See, we learnt the uses of the water, whereas we considered as the waste water when the pollutants and different types of objects or the substance will mixed in the water, where no more useful for us, then we considered as a waste water. See, the waste water is nothing but the water which is no more useful for us and other living organisms are called as waste water. And this waste water, which may includes the oil substance, like rich in lather. Lather is nothing but the nore. After washing the cloth, the lather will be obtained. Means nothing but the nore. Oil substance or the rich in lather. And next. And other pollutants that goes down to the drain from the sink, pollutants. See, pollutants means other substance which is not useful for the consumption of the drinking water. So that these substance we call it as a pollutants. And see, when waste water we consider as a waste when there is no more useful for us, and such a type of water we call it as a waste water. And usually the waste water contains the mixed oil substance and which is rich in lather. Lather is nothing but the nore, and pollutants which usually mix up with the pollutants. And these water which goes into the drain, see, these water goes into the drain from the drain to the sink. Say these water like oil substance, rich in lather, pollutants which goes through the drain, goes into the drain through the sink, from the toilet, and from the shower after washing, after bathing, the water which left over is nothing but the waste water. And see, these water which we consider as a waste water. See, waste water, when we consider as a waste, when no more useful for us, we call it as a waste water. And here the waste water includes the oily substance and rich in lather and having the pollutants and which is not useful for us. And these water will goes into the drain through the sink, from the toilet, and from the shower. Thereby we can say that the waste water will collect. And at the same time, if these water will not drain, will not clean these water, means we get many other waterborne diseases. See, we use lots of water in our daily life for bathing purpose, for washing and like that, etc. We use the water in a very much different activities purpose. And like that, usually the 22nd March, see, 22nd March is considered as World Water Day. Since the Government of Assembly, UN, proclaimed that to save the water and for usually for drinking purpose, we have to use the water. See, 22nd March we considered as the World Water Day. Since the government of assembly UNO proclaimed the use of water, and without wasting the water we have to conserve the water, and this 22 March as I told you considered to be the World Water Day, which brings the awareness amongst the people for safe water, and which is usually fit for human consumption. Brings awareness amongst people to save water for human consumption. Say 22 March is considered to be the World Water Day, and usually the assembly of UNO proclaimed the World Water Day, and all the efforts are made to bring the awareness among the peoples to save the water for the human consumption. And see, this is all about the World Water Day. Next we shall move on to the another concept. Usually the clean water is very important, and it is one of the basic need for human beings and all living organisms. And unfortunately the clean water is not available in nowadays, because there is a pollutants will mixed in such a water, and many waterborne disease will bacteria will be present, and so that we have to save and conserve these water, otherwise there is no more water will be present on the earth, and usually which is not used for human consumption, so that we have to conserve the water in a proper way. See, clean water is useful for human beings and different living creatures in the earth. See, if the water is unfit for human consumption, it may create some many other diseases and disorders. Water unfit for the drinking purpose means it may create some diseases and disorder for the human and other living creature in the earth, like waterborne diseases. Waterborne diseases it may get, and ultimately leads to the loss of human life. Loss of human life. See, the water is unfit for human consumption, which may lead the waterborne diseases, and which may lose the human life. And see, these are the uses of water and how the clean water is useful for all living organisms. And next we shall move on to the, so this is all about the how the water is very essential and how water play a vital role in our life. And next one is the dealing with the garbage. See, I already told about the garbage, that is the waste. That is two types of waste are there, biodegradable waste and another one is the non-biodegradable waste. And those waste which is acted by the microorganisms, we call it as a biodegradable. And those which can't be acted on the microorganisms are called as non-biodegradable waste. And see how the dealing with the garbage will be takes place. We have to treat it the garbage in a proper way. Later, one by one steps will be present in the treatment of the garbage. We will learn now. Dealing with the garbage. See, nature of the garbage is treated and disposed of in a different places. That is, in different ways we can treat it and dispose. Treat it and dispose. See, in the garbage, both the biodegradable waste and as well as the non-biodegradable waste are present. First, we have to remove the biodegradable waste from the non-biodegradable waste. And later, we have to treat it and dispose of in different ways. There are different ways will be present to deal with the garbage. In which, first one is the landfill. See, in which first one is the landfill. Some of the garbage are non-biodegradable one and some of them are biodegradable waste are present and taken into the low-lying areas or the places. See, these garbage is taken into the low-lying area. See, low-lying area or the places is nothing but Tegu Pradesha. See, like that we have to take out these garbage into the low-lying areas and dumped in a, for making one pit and dumped these waste or the garbage. We have to dump in a pit by making the pit and dumped in a pit. And after dumping these garbage, we have to add the soil into this garbage. And after leaving some days or some month, we can notice that these soil will become black in color. Indicates that this is a fertile soil. And these fertile soil can be useful for growing the plants and development of the plants. See, non-useful garbage are spread out in the landfill areas and converted with the soil. Once the landfill is completely filled up and these landfill will be utilized for several years and it is converted into the parks, playground and also no buildings were built in such a areas for some days. And see, this is all about the landfill and how the landfill will be takes place. See, first of all, dealing with the garbage. How they will deal with the garbage means first they will treat it with the garbage and disposed of in the low-lying areas. See, garbage is taken into the low-lying areas, nothing but the Tegu Bhumi. After that, first they will make one pit and dump these waste, like biodegradable waste, they will dump into this pit and later they will add the soil into that pit. And after several months, these soil will become black in color and this soil is nothing but the humus due to the bacteria will be present and which is useful for the growth as well as the development of the plant. See, after the dumping, the waste will convert it into the humus and due to the action of microorganisms like bacteria, fungi and virus, these soil will becomes the black in color, and usually the soil which contains the nutrient which is essential for the growth and development of the plant. See, next we shall move on to the composting. After this landfill, another step is the composting. See, composting is nothing but biodegradable things which becomes rot or degrade by the action of the microorganisms, and it is converted into the manure, is called as composting. The rotting and the conversion of these materials into manure is called as composting. Conversion of biodegradable waste the rotting and conversion of the biodegradable waste into the manure is called as composting. See, composting is nothing but the rotting and the conversion of the biodegradable waste into the manure is called as composting. Usually composting takes place with the help of microorganisms present in the soil. See, this is the definition. See, composting takes place by the action of microorganisms. See, these microorganisms usually present in the soil, and thereby these microorganisms will acted on the biodegradable waste which we dumped in the pit, and later these microorganisms will rotten the materials, that is the waste, and later it will convert it into the manure. And if the manure is take out and spread into the growing plants, then it will grow the plants very fast nature. And see, this is all about the composting. First process is the landfill. First they will dump the waste into the land, and in that waste they will cover the soil into that after leaving some months, and these soil becomes the manure, and this soil becomes the microorganisms will acted upon these waste, and later the soil becomes a fertile one. And after that the composting by the action of microorganisms, these soil will becomes converted into the manure, and thereby no more buildings will be constructed for several days and due to the composting process. And next one is the, see, composting is nothing but the rotting and the conversion of the waste into the manure is called as composting. And this composting takes place by the action of microorganisms present in the soil. And next one is the another step, burning of the leaves and plants. See, it is not a type of this dealing with the garbage. Just I will tell you what will happen if we burn the plants and their parts. What will happen if the plants will dry up and later it will fall on the ground, means we have to make use of it. Instead of burning these leaves and the plant body, we can reuse this plant body as a leaf, and different parts we can spread into the soil so that it will becomes the manure, and thereby we can converted these burning these leaves and different parts of the plant, we can make use of manure, in the form of a manure. See, most of the time dry leaves are burnt. Usually many people will burn the leaves in the roadside. Burn leaves near the roadside, which may create the pollution, like air pollution it will create. And during the process of burning, the leaves will emit the vapors, or the smoke will be produced, and different poisonous gas will be produced during burning process. And so that these may affect for living organisms, and human beings, asthma will be attacked, and many other airborne disease will be occur due to the burning process. And so that we can make use of these dry leaves, instead of burning, we have to make it into the soil, and thereby the soil is converted into the manure form. And like that, the burning of the leaves will very dangerous in the environment, which may leads to the emission of the gases produced by the burning of leaves, and air pollution will be occur. See, air pollution means the pollution, malinya. Air pollution means vayu malinya. See, we can reduce the air pollution by not burning the leaves and other parts of the plant. Instead of this, we can make use of another techniques. We can use this leaf as well as the plant, and cover the soil, and so that it will convert it into the manure form, and later the which will helpful for the plant to grow. And like that, we can you make use of the leaves and the parts. See, burning of the leaves, which may create the smoke, and poisonous gases will be produced, which may affect ill effect for the human life and other creature in the earth. So this is all about the burning of the leaves. Next one is the burning of the leaves. We observe in the roadside, many of the people will burn the leaves of the plant, and thereby it will leads to the smoke and different gases, which is very poisonous for us. And if we inhale these gases, we will get the asthma and many other airborne diseases. Usually the farmer burns the husk after harvesting. See, we have to minimize the burning process, and which may lead to the many health hazards. So that instead of burning the leaves and plants, we can make use of another methods. And next we shall move on to the the smoke and different gases will be produced during the burning process. We have to minimize the burning process and to stop such practices, and these waste could be converted into the useful compost. These waste will the burning of leaves, instead of burning the leaves, we can make use of these waste could be converted into the useful compost. And the government have make a law against the burning of the plants and the plants product. See, this is all about the different methods which we seen while dealing with the garbage. First one is the landfill method, and next one is the composting, and in which we have to make a compost by using the different leaves, and instead of burning the leaves, which may leads to the poisonous gas, which emit the poisonous gas, which is dangerous for all living organisms, and which may creates the air pollution, and also airborne diseases will be occur. And so that we have to minimize the burning of the leaves and the trees, and so that instead of burning, we have to make it use by these leaves can be converted into the compost by keeping the leaves and plants in the soil, and after that we have to put the soil over to the leaves and plants, so that after some time, after some days, it will become some manure or compost. So like that we have to minimize. In today's class we will learn about the biodegradable waste, non-biodegradable waste, and also we learned about the how the water is very essential and how the wastewater will be produced in day-to-day life activities, like washing the utensils. We can use the water, and these water we consider as a waste, where no more useful for us, so that it is considered to be a waste. And also we learnt about the dealing with the garbage, in which landfill, composting and vermicomposting will be there. And later in the next class we will learn about the vermicomposting. So we will meet in the next class. Stay safe, stay home, and keep learning. Thank you.